We are back here on GMA. What are we going to do, Michael? We're going to Usher.
Yeah, that's right.
Usher in the new week. Love how you do that. But global superstar, eight-time Grammy winner Usher. He just kicked off a residency at the Colosseum at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. And Usher, welcome back. Welcome back to G.
It's a pleasure to be here with you guys. How you guys doing?
We're great seeing you.
Great.
Okay, I'm going to ask you now.
That's wonderful. I'm just warming up, just coming off the high of my opening weekend.
Oh.
I'm getting it ready for you guys to come out here in Las Vegas. You got your tickets. You know you guys are going to have a great time when you come. Everybody that always came.
Always
we
a good
had a great time.
Always a good time with you. And
yeah,
looking
man.
Good. Looking good. So did you get the haircut not just for the residency? That's a good look.
Oh yeah, no. You know, with me, I'm always, you know, introducing something new. Mm-hmm. But yeah, the haircut definitely goes with the residency. But it's going to be here for a while too, so get used to it.
Well, speaking of introducing something new, last time you were on the show, it was right before your baby daughter was born last September, and now you and your girlfriend, you expected another baby. So congratulations, man. And are you ready to are you ready to change two sets of diapers?
Well, I mean, I better get ready. There's no other choice. But definitely enjoying, you know, this little baby boom of ours.
and the backstage experience, though, it must be a little different with babies in the mix now.
It is. You know, and hey, it's been that way for some time, but this new addition to the family has just been exciting. We can't wait. I'm loving being a girl dad for once. You know, I'm even changing my colors. I'm wearing pink and cool stuff like that. You know,
does she have a favorite Usher song?
Have never been. Do they have a favorite Usher song? You know, I do wish that my kids listened to my music more. My second son, Naveed, he actually really is the one who listens to my music more than anything. Usher, he doesn't care. Sovereign, she just likes me to sing to her.
Any of them going to become musicians, you think?
I hope that Naveed does. Usher got my name, Sovereign. She's just screams, but she screams oddly in key. You know?
That's saying something, screaming in key like that.
Yeah.
So, Usher, you have so many hit songs. How did you decide what to perform there in Vegas?
It was kind of a trial and error. You know, I just wanted to make sure that, you know, if you were a new fan or if you're a fan who just, you know, become a part of it and really want energy, I wanted to make sure I covered everything. So I went all the way back to the first album and I gave a little bit of all of them, even played a couple of B-sides, some, you know, features. But man, it's going to be an amazing show like none other in terms of the techniques, you know, the dancing, the wardrobe. I spared no expense in making sure that this was an incredible show.
You know, it's been more than 15 years since you released Confessions, one of my favorite albums. Obviously, everybody loved it because it was a top solo album of the 2000s. And we hear you working on new music, so can we expect a new album this year?
You've heard some new songs, definitely working on new music. You know, I have a bit of a goal. You know, I would love for Confessions to actually peak selling 20 million albums, and we're not that far. We're actually really, really, really close. Me and my mother were just talking about it as she was here over the weekend for the opening. But I'm hoping, man, if we can get that thing over 20 million, it would be really an amazing thing. Just for history, you know?
All right, I'm going to go buy it again.
Another piece of... And then also to get ready for new music. So it's coming soon.
You were part of another piece of history. You went to the White House to celebrate Juneteenth becoming a national holiday with President Biden. That must have been a meaningful experience.
And beyond, you know, many years ago at the Essence Fest, you know, I wore a T-shirt that actually it had the 4th of July on it, and it had Juneteenth underneath. And this was really an awakening, you know, for, you know, my people just to understand our independence. So to see, you know, Oprah Lee be there for the writing in and it becoming an official holiday, it really means a lot for us as African, as Native Black Americans. And, you know, just for America to celebrate our culture the same way we celebrate so many other cultures, whether it's, you know, Puerto Rican or Mexican or any other culture. America is a multitude of color. And I'm just happy that my culture is seen and our independence is recognized.
Well said.
Well said. Thank you. Always good to have you here on GMA.
Thank you guys so much. Listen, I will definitely hold a spot for you guys front and center. Michael, you're going to be in the pit, of course. And I look forward to seeing you guys here in Las Vegas. I love you all, man, and I hope to see you soon.
Right back at you. And we've got a lot more ahead with Usher taking us backstage at his new Las Vegas residency. Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.